1973 tennis, the one before this burnt down from the Great Fire of London. I'm going to talk about that in a minute, so I'm going to talk about London's newest development. This one is on the right, slight curve, on the side of it.
Yeah, yeah, bago lang yan.
The baby bump, the boomerang, the vase, the cocktail shaker. I've heard that London is a gone with this one. It's the King of Dashin. Why? If you do want to live up there, you need £22 million to do so. But you will be living in the exclusive address of number one. But we are indeed in the era of Blackfriars, better known for Blackfriars 2.5 when it's here. The first one is Victoria Fitton Road Bridge, Old Victoria Fitton Road Bridge. Big one, Golden Pins. Ahead of us, we have Blackfriars Station Bridge. The Gentleman's Bridge ahead of us there. £5 million over budget in 5 years length as well. In the Vatican City. It was also one of London's tallest buildings, stands at 365 feet high in the air, 1 foot every day of the year. You might recognise there's not a lot of tall buildings in the cathedral, and that's because the cathedral is protected by a law that states that St Paul's must be visible from 13 key points across the City of London. One of those being the City of London's Fulton Hall is on our left over there. That's why the building has a glass atrium and glass roof. Many famous occasions have taken place at St Paul's Cathedral. The Queen celebrating her 90th birthday celebrations. The wedding between Lady Diana and Prince Charles, and the funeral of Sir Winston Churchill. Apparently it was most of Churchill's most favoured
and how did that rainbow?
If St Paul's was to be
the morale
the
as
well. St Paul's was never bombed. There was a bomb that went through the dome of the cathedral. Luckily it was a dome. It was only said to make the building a bit
wobbly. Wobbly then.
Coming up there with a thatch roof flying high as the detailed replica of Shakespeare's Globe. Yeah. Where is it? So American, Sam Wanamaker, playwright, director, actor, came to London in the 1990s and wanted to pay homage to the great bard William Shakespeare. And there was nothing here to commemorate William Shakespeare. So he took it upon himself to design this detailed replica of the original Shakespeare's Globe. It's apparently an amalgamation of the Rose and Swan, that globe over there. But it was built using the same methods as the original. No electronics in there, using all the validation methods designed by the theatre. All built to near enough the same specifications as its original as well. So a little bit smaller. This area though, on the right, if you were around in the Jacobean era, you fancy the naughty night on the town. This is the area you would come to find your pubs, your brothels, your theatre, your tavern, illegal gambling, bare boxing, wrestling, dog fighting, cock fighting, bear baiting. My kind of Friday night. It is the area of Southwark, the den of sin and debauchery. As we come under Southwark Bridge,